What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here, and it has begun testing on the Epic 7742 64 core, 128 thread, 256 megabytes of L3 cache CPU mining beast. So what's going on here is we're going to be testing the Random X algorithm. Most of you know that as the algorithm that Monero XMR does run on. Now there's quite a few coins, around 11 of them, that actually use this algorithm as well. So these hash rates and power consumptions and everything will work on all of these coins. This is what you will expect for all of them. And that does consist of, you know, Monero, Dagger, Epic Cash, Quantum RL, Veal, Bible Pay, Yada Coin, Dynasty Coin, Exultum, whatever that is, Graft, I'm not sure about the XG part, and then of course we got Zephyr at the bottom there as well. So this will be the hash rates and power consumption on all of those coins. All right, so to start off, to let us know how we're going to do the testing here is, as we know, the Epic 7742 has 8 channels and it uses 8 sticks of RAM, and RandomX does love its memory. So we're going to run through the DIMM slots here, and that is the slots that your actual RAM fits into. And for full 8 channel RAM, you know, that's all the slots here used up. But we're going to go through the numbering scheme here, and if you're unfamiliar and all that good stuff there. But when we did build this, if you saw when we built this beast, we pointed all the labels toward the CPU this way and this way, and the labeling of the slots is pretty much the same. So starting from here, you can see your VGA here. This is the bottom with your PCI Express. We're starting from the inside and working our way out. So we got A1, B, C, D, 1, all these, they're all ones, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, you know, all ones, but we got A, B, C, D, and then starting over here again, E, F, G, H. So that's how our RAM is going into here. Now, when it comes to the slots of how many sticks you got to do, you need to use certain slots, whether you're running 8 sticks, 6 sticks, actually 6 sticks is not recommended. So we might skip that one and I'll update it some other time in my spreadsheet. But we're going to run 8 sticks, 4 sticks, 2 sticks, and 1 stick and see how each one of these affect the performance and power of our mining capabilities on RandomX. So here's the actual chart from the motherboard manufacturer of how all the DIMM slots should go, depending if you're using 1, 2, 4, or all 8 slots. And just to add it up here, here you can see this is the slot you would put just for a single stick of RAM. This is the slot you would use for 2 sticks of RAM. This is the slot you would use for 4 sticks of RAM. Then obviously for 8 channels, you would use all the slots for all the RAM. All right, and for our first test, we're gonna be using maximum hash rate here. Default settings, these Epics are running, you know, pretty much on default. I don't know how to overclock them or anything yet based on this motherboard. If I figure it out, I'm able to do some tweaking. Maybe I'll try Windows sometime as well. And Ryzen Master, there's another program out there that's actually supposed to work on Epic, so we'll try that. But right now we're gonna do everything at stock settings and 8 sticks of RAM. So let's take a look at our hash rates and power consumption. All right, so here we can see on RandomX Monero, we're doing about 47.9 kilohash, which is 47,900 hashes. Temperatures are looking good, actually. We're at 64 degrees at about 25 degrees ambient. Now, the other couple days here, it was very hot out, and we were sitting around 72 degrees when it was like 33 degrees ambient coming in. So when it gets hot out, this does run around 72, but I think we're well within reason. These coolers and that Mod My Mod's thermal paste seems to be doing well, because now we're around normal room temperatures and hanging out, mining away full blast at 64 degrees Celsius. So that's looking good. At the wall, we are about 336 watts. All right, so we are now in 4 channel mode, and I believe each stick actually counts as its own individual channel, which means when we have all 8 in, we're at 8 channels. So right now, I believe we're in 4 channel mode. We have 4 sticks of RAM in, skipping the 2 inside ones on each side and using the 2 outside for this setup. So now let's take a look at our hash rates and power consumption in 4 channel mode. All right, so here we are in quad channel, and as expected, we did lose a little bit of hash rate, but we're hanging out about 43.12 kilohash, or 43,120 hashes. We're at 62 degrees.
Our thread performance is obviously down a little bit because we are... total hash is down a little bit, but at the wall we are using, we're peaking in around that 307 watt mark. So our power actually went down a decent amount as well. It'll be interesting once we work out all the efficiencies later on when we go through the spreadsheet.
Okay, so now we are in dual channel mode. We are only using slots C and D1 here, and here everything else is removed, two sticks of RAM. This is the same dual channel mode that we would see in normal consumer grade CPUs, like your 3000, 5000, 7000, you know, 7950Xs, 7900, and vice versa with the 3 and 5000 series type of modes here. So now we're running the same type of channels here, dual channel mode. Let's take a look at our hash rates and power consumptions.
All right, so here we can actually see a pretty big drop in dual channel mode at 26.79 kilohash. Our temps are down to 55 degrees, and at the wall we're hanging out at about 260 watts. So it'll be interesting to see again how all the efficiencies and everything play out, but dual channel mode does drop that hash rate quite a bit. Now let's move on over to check out single channel.
All right, guys, so now we are in single channel mode. One single stick of RAM hanging out in the C1 slot. So now we're just gonna let this thing boot up, fire up. We'll get some hash rates, power consumptions, and see just how poorly one stick does on random max.
Okay, and in single channel, we're doing about 12.9 kilohash, 52 degrees. And at the wall, we're about 234 watts or so at the peak. It is jumping around quite a bit here, but there we go. That is our single channel test. So I'm going to get all these plugged into the spreadsheet, and we're going to look at some efficiencies to see what's the best setting to use. But we can definitely see from 8 sticks down to 1 stick on RandomX, there is a huge difference in hash rate. And honestly, the price of this thing is not worth it for a single stick. All right, so here's the final results of all the numbers we did through testing. And a lot of you guys probably just fast forward and skip to the end to look at this. I don't know, we'll find out, but let me know what you did down in the comments section. Maybe just rewind it, watch us at minus times 2 speed, just to give a little more watch time. I'm just kidding, do whatever you guys want. Regardless, hit that subscribe button, guys. We are looking at the Epic 7742 on RandomX. So here we have 8 sticks of RAM, 47.9 kilohash was our hash rate at 336 watts. That actually worked out to be our highest efficiency that we had at 142.559. So it's looking like it loves those 8 sticks of RAM. We were sitting at about 64 degrees on the temps here. That's in Celsius. Sitting at 4 sticks of RAM, we lost a little bit of hash rate at 43.12 kilohash. 307 watts. This is all full system at the wall. That was a hash to watt ratio of 140.456 hashes per watt of power at 62 C's. 2 sticks of RAM is 26.79 kilohash. We did see a decent drop here coming from quad core down to dual channel here at 260 watts. We didn't lose enough power to make that hash rate drop worthwhile, as well as the price. 103.038 hash to watt at 55 C's, and your single stick of RAM here was only 12.9 kilohash, 234 watts, 55.128 hash per watt, making it red our worst efficiency numbers of them all. And we were only running at 52 degrees Celsius.
All right, guys, so there we have it. Those are our hash rates for RandomX, XMR, you know, all the coins on the RandomX algorithm for the Epic 7742 Mining Beast server grade CPU miner here. So obviously here, 8 sticks of RAM, 8 channels definitely is the best way to run this on RandomX. It'll be very interesting when we check out other coins like algorithms here. We got Ghost Rider for Raptorium, Bittorium, and so on. You know, we got Dero on Astrobot, and you know, there's other coins out there, Verus Coin and so on. And a lot of those ones, when it came with the consumer grade CPUs, RAM sticks didn't matter, the speed didn't matter, didn't matter if you overclocked your RAM, anything, you didn't notice really any hash rate differences. So it'll be very interesting when we try those other coins if a single stick will actually perform like 8 sticks, and then we could see a possible power drop quite a bit by not having to use any power for all the remaining 7 sticks. So it's going to be some interesting times ahead checking out those other coins here. But let me know your thoughts and opinions on this CPU down in the comment section below. I will see you all in the next one. Rabbit out.